We've just arrived at the Supercar Driver event here at RAF Scampston. I'm here with none other than Adam Thorby, the founder of Supercar Driver. What a great event. First of all, we are currently, 50 feet above the ground in this cherry picker. And behind us, we've got a line up of 100 supercars. Tell me about this event. I missed it last year, stupidly.
It was, last year was our first event. This year, we have stepped it up a bit. We've learned a lot of lessons from last time.
Yeah.
This is hosted by the Red Arrows, you know, the guys that we all admire.
Yeah,
they put this together with us and let us all come down here. So, yeah, it's pretty cool, isn't it?
Great event. It's funny, normally I'll turn up to these events and go straight over to the best car.
Yep.
This time I've turned up and gone over straight to a Red Arrow, which is amazing.
It's mad, isn't
it? It's so good. So what's the format of the day?
We're starting with this epic group photo.
Yep.
And then there are various parades. The cars are split into groups of 20. There's a hypercar parade going up first. They all have two or three laps on the track. And then we work through the groups. Obviously, it's worth saying as well, when you turned up, we took a donation off you for charity.
Yes.
And we hope to raise about $6,000, I think, if everyone donates. And
all right. And what's the charity?
It's John Egan Trust, which is the pilot, Red Arrows pilot, that lost his life in 2011 at Bournemouth.
Yeah.
It's for those, his charity. And then a percentage of that, a smaller percentage, will also go to Bluebellwood Children's Hospice, who is something that we support and we've supported for about 5 years now. So
fantastic.
Yeah, it's cool because we can use these cars for a good thing, for a good, you know, so the drivers have an awesome day. We give money to charity, everyone wins.
Win-win, absolutely.
Yeah,
and so, as well as me filming today, you guys, I've noticed your crew down here.
Yeah, we've got a full-on crew. Yeah,
so after this video, be sure to go and check out Supercar Driver's channel. They've got much fancier cameras than I have, so I'm expecting big things.
Yeah, me too. Actually, we've got Riyadh's brother Nathan. He's leading it today. He's presenting it. So for once, we've got a face, and we're going to show a bit behind the scenes, I think. So
fantastic.
Cool.
Thanks a lot, Adam.
Cheers, James.
Cheers, mate.
See you, mate.
Cheers. Okay, we have arrived at RAF Scampton, and behind me is an airfield of 150 of the world's best supercars. We've all got the cars lined up perfectly for what is going to be a phenomenal photo shoot. Again, the words aren't going to quite do it justice, so after this segment I'm going to take you along for a more beautiful ride. But some of the cars here are absolutely insane. We've got a road legal FXX 918, several Super Veloce Aventadors, the list goes on and on and on. Yeah. Without further ado, let's chat, more show. We are here with a familiar face again. Last time I was speaking to you was about your winning Millimilia 599. Still got the wristband
still got
on.
The wristband.
That's
free espressos anywhere. Anywhere I go, James.
If you flash that in Italy, they bow down.
That's free espresso.
But now you're telling me that this F430 that you've modified quite a lot was going to be the original car.
Yeah, that this was going to be the original race car, James, and we had I had a co-driver that was going to join me, and he got really pretty ill, and we decided to change the car to do the race in the 599. But when we started the build on this car, we were trying to make what we considered would be the ultimate Millimilia car. So we wanted to have it really, really capable on the road, but also not too sort of focused that it would be unstable.
Sure.
So we managed to take what Ferrari had started with and make some modifications.
It sounds like you've given it the Scuderia treatment and then some.
we're now lighter than a Scuderia.
Fantastic.
And it's interesting to contrast. I'm an engineer by trade, so it's interesting to contrast Ferrari's approach
to losing
weight and our approach. So the first thing here is the carbon front air guide, which is which on the stock car is body coloured, but it's also amazingly heavy. Then the next thing that we did moving backwards was we upgraded the car to the carbon brakes. This was running on steel brakes originally.
Okay.
And we also put the Challenge wheels with titanium bolts.
Wow.
So those titanium bolts will save 1.5 kilos.
Every little helps.
Every little bit helps, yeah. What we did was we changed the geometry a little bit to make sure that the car you know, would handle really well. But we've kept the suspension travel, because one of the things about road racing is that the roads are not perfect. So unlike a track focused car, like a Scuderia, you know, you've got to be able to soak up those potholes and the, and those occasional
bumps. And which through Italy there are quite a lot.
Let's just say Italy Italy's roads are varied.
Off-road.
Varied. They are varied.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I guess inside you can see some big changes, because in period the car was available with carbon trim.
Right.
But most 430s have got like an aluminium look to them.
Yeah.
This is one of the single biggest weight savings.
Seats.
Was these race seats, these carbon back race seats. They are a Ferrari item. And I think up until the 458 option came out, these are where the lightest fully trimmed leather carbon seats you can get. But as you can see, everything carbon inside. We took the stock manifolds out.
Yeah,
and you probably can't see them, but buried in there are some stainless steel replacement manifolds.
So you've gone all out of there.
We've gone all out. Yeah.
Yeah.
The carbon interior here saves a lot of weight, and these carbon air boxes, these are from a Scuderia. We've adapted them to fit the standard engine.
You've done some work on this, haven't you?
Titanium cap here.
Oh yeah.
Saves a few grams. And. And the exhaust, also to get the exhaust free flowing. This is a really weirdly rare Japanese market tubey pipes.
Yes.
I have got another exhaust, which is current, which I designed and somebody fabricated for me. but we're running the stock silencer today.
Wow.
And then this piece at the back end here.
That is
good. This is what
right?
you could, this is, yeah, what they call a challenge back end. We had it weighed on the weighbridge the other day.
Yes.
And we've taken out 128 kilos over the stock car.
That's so no small feat. That's good.
The Scuderia is 100
yes,
kilos.
Yes, it is,
out.
Yeah.
So we're,
wow.
So we're almost there. When we change the silencer, I think we'll be 30 kilos less than a Scuderia.
Fantastic.
With the airboxes and the manifolds and a little bit of a remap, we're up to 555 horsepower.
So together with that, the power to weight ratio is quite a jump.
Yeah, yeah. So it will,
great piece of gear.
You know, it will outperform a Scuderia on the road.
Yes.
As you know, James, I'm a road racer at heart, that's the thing.
Yeah, yeah.
So yeah, it's been a very, very rewarding project. I mean, when we got we got that number on the scales, really fantastic. It was in a waste recycling centre, and you pay 13 quid to get your car weighed. And we were jumping up and down. They said, "What the hell? You know, why are you jumping up and down?"
We need to get out in this. I think one day we should do a video on it, because I actually was a 430 Scuderia owner.
Oh right,
so
yeah,
it'd be really interesting to compare them.
I think that would
absolutely
be a fantastic exercise. Yeah.
All right, Chris, well, there's another 150 cars here, and I'm not going to do an interview like that on every one of them.
Well, you enjoy the rest of the day, James, and I'll see you soon.
The idea now, then, is we have a parade lap, and we're going to get some awesome photos and footage. Is that...
I hope so. I mean,
that's the plan, man.
That's what usually works.
Yeah.
Am
I leaving him behind? Just decided to do an interview mid-runway. Do I even need to plug this back in? He's in, he's back. We're getting left behind!
I had to do a piece to camera!
What we're gonna do is you hold that and we're gonna remold your face.
Thank you.
was good. I don't know how they do it. Honestly, it's so good.
No, the jokes aside, this is... Oh my God.
Oh, it's so cool.
It just, that much power and that much aggression should be breaking traction.
And it doesn't. It's ridiculous. Okay. Honestly, man, it's witchcraft. The guys at McLaren, they have some magic formula.
They have really done the job on this car, haven't they?
Coming towards the end of the day, but behind me is exactly the reason why this event is so fantastic. We've got a Road Legal FXX MyLT and a plane from the Red Arrows all in situ for people to just line up and take pictures with. When's the next time a picture like that is going to happen? It's fantastic. Anyway, we are coming towards the end of the day, so I'm gonna hop back in the LT. I've got quite a drive home, and see you next time. Ciao.